everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today I am going to discuss about the syllabus of Mumbai University of Strength of Materials. Here on the screen you can see I have made a mind map for the same. Let's start discussing about it. This is the central idea of the entire mind map, which is going to revolve around the strength of materials. The prerequisites for studying this course are Applied Mathematics SEM 1 and 2, Engineering Mechanics Semester 1. The students of the third semester will have differently studied Engineering Mechanics in the SEM 1, and Basic Mathematics of Standard 11th and 12th. If you have come from first year to the second year, or if you are a diploma student, then the Diploma Mathematics is important. I have marked here that Strength of Materials for Mumbai University is in third semester. The course code is MEC302 in the current C scheme. The course credit is going to be 3. Now let's discuss about the syllabus. Like any other subject of Mumbai University, Strength of Materials is also going to have 6 modules. The first module can be asked for approximately 25 to 30 marks. This is just a judgment which I am making based on the previous few years' paper which I have analyzed. The first module is stresses and strains. The time given for this module is 8 hours. In this first module, these are the main topics to be studied. The first is introduction to stresses and strain, wherein you study what is stress, what is strain, what are its types, what are the loadings coming on a particular beam or column, what is Hooke's law. So all those things come in stresses strain, and most importantly, what are the units for each of them. The second topic, which is very important, is elastic constants. There are 3 of them, E, K and G. E stands for Young's modulus, K stands for bulk modulus, and G stands for shear modulus or modulus of rigidity, as it is called. So these are the 3 elastic constants, and there is a relation between 3 of them. So that is what is to be studied in the second topic which I have mentioned. The third topic which you see over here is temperature stresses. Suppose if a body is subjected to temperature and say it is fixed from one end or 2 ends, then the body will undergo some kind of stresses and it will show some kind of deformation. So the stresses which are generated on the body because of rise in temperature are generally temperature stresses. So along with stress, there will also be strain, because this stress is something which leads to strain, or I can say the factor which leads to strain is stress. So stress is there, that means strain definitely has to be there. It could be increase in length or it could be a decrease in length. Next comes principal stresses and principal planes. Here you are going to study about the stress and strain which is acting on the principal plane. There are 2 of them, a major and a minor axis. So what are the stresses, maximum stress and minimum stress, which are coming on the 2 axes is what is to be studied here. In this topic also comes the concept of Mohr's circle and its diagrammatic representation. The last topic which is important here is moment of inertia. This is very, very important, because based on moment of inertia, there are many concepts in this world. So this is very important. All these topics which I discuss over here, I'm going to add the notes of all of them in this channel, so you can learn about them in depth later on. This is just an introduction video, so I will just superficially explain things to you. The second module, approximately it is asked for 15 to 20 marks. This module is very simple. It is rule based. It is called as SFD, BMD and AFD. SFD stands for shear force diagram, BMD stands for bending moment diagram, and AFD stands for axial force diagram. This topic has been allotted 6 hours by the university, which is fair enough. And there are all sign conventions and the curves which are used for drawing the SFD, BMD and AFD for a particular loading coming on a beam. So this is just rule based. So you should know what kind of convention you are using. Say any shear force acting in the upward direction will be positive, any shear force in the downward direction will be negative. And here shear force upward and downward is always considered with respect to a particular axis. Similarly, for bending moment and for axial force, there is a particular axis to the left or right we will have to see, and in which direction the force is acting. So just those rules and you can draw a very correct diagram. So this is for 15 to 20 marks, very important. Next comes module 3. This is generally asked 15 to 20 marks. The topic is labeled as stresses and beams in the syllabus. It has been allotted 8 hours and there are two main topics here. One is bending stresses and the other is shear stresses. In the previous syllabus, there was another topic which was direct and combined stresses, which has been removed now, and there are only two topics as you can see. So suppose there is a beam and there is some loading on it, so because of which over a period of time you will see some amount of bending which is formed in the beam. So that is nothing but what you study in bending stresses. And when there is a load at a particular section, the section is bound to get sheared because there will be supports from below and there will be load from above. You can just take the example of your building in which you stay. The floor in which you are staying will be having, say, two columns at two ends and there will be a beam. So you can imagine the columns are providing the support and the beam is subjected to the load which is coming from the floor above you. So the beam will remain steady, but the rods inside, the reinforcements, over a period of time will be subjected to some amount of bending. And wherever there is load acting, say if you have a point load which is concentrated at particular ends, there will be shear forces acting. So that is what you study in this module 3. Module 4 is asked for 20 to 25 marks. The two topics over here are torsion and deflection of beams. Each can be allotted approximately 3 hours for teaching and learning both. In torsion, you generally design the shaft which is subjected to torsion effect, or rather I would say to torque. An example would be the shaft or the rod which you see of your fan. So one end of the rod is fixed and the other end is subjected to a rotation effect, nothing but torque. So that rod or the shaft, which I would call, is what you design in this chapter of torsion. And there are two criteria based on which you design. One is strength criteria and one is rigidity criteria. So based on which you have to solve, you will also have to study the shafts in series and parallel. So these are the various topics which you will cover in the module 4 of torsion. And the other very important topic is deflection of beams. In the previous syllabus, it was in the 5th module. Now it has been shifted to the 4th module. And here you can study the slope and deflection calculation on a particular beam by the help of Macaulay's method. Macaulay's method is quite simple and that is just formula based, and you just need to know how to integrate. So it is very easy to solve after you know that. So I have approximately given 20 to 25 marks to this module, and I assume it will be approximately not more than 20, but at all say 10 marks numerical from torsion and 10 from beam, or it could be just 10 marks numerical from deflection of beam and 5 marks theory from torsion. It could be that way as well. So this marks is not something which is rigid. It is just an assumption which I have made based on the topics and their importance, because generally a torsion numerical is asked for 10 marks and numerical of deflection of beams is asked for 10 marks. And if at all a theory is asked, say a derivation from the torsion chapter, then it could be for additional 5 marks. So that is why I have written 20 to 25 marks. Okay, next shift to module 5. Module 5 can be asked for 10 to 15 marks. Here there are two topics included in the syllabus, thin cylinder and spherical shells, on which you can invest around 3 hours, which is fair enough. There are many subtopics in this, in which the most important thing or the most important concept which you need to know is cylindrical and longitudinal stresses. And for strain energy, you can invest 3 hours. And strain energy topic is very simple. There are just few formulas which you need to know, and based on which you can solve the numericals. Strain energy chapter is basically about a body which is subjected to some kind of load, and if there's a load on the body, there will be some amount of stress generated. When there is stress, there is obviously going to be some amount of strain in the body, and this strain leads to a storage of energy in the body, which is called as strain energy. Say there is a particular floor on which a block falls suddenly. So if there is a sudden loading or there is a gradual application of load on a particular body, then what is the deformation and what is the amount of strain induced? and because of which there will be some strain energy. That is what you study here. Module 6 can be asked for 10 to 15 marks. This module has not changed in the previous two schemes as well. This is all about columns, wherein you study long columns. When it is subjected to load, it could be showing some kind of compressive effect and also some kind of buckling effect. Buckling is the bending of the long columns. So there are two methods of calculation of the buckling load or the crippling load, as it is called: Euler's method and Rankine-Gordon formula. They are just formula based, extremely simple numericals. And there is another small subtopic which is added, that is Euler's limitations. What is the limitation of Euler's method that we had to shift for Rankine-Gordon formula? Otherwise, initially Euler's formula is used. So there's some limitations, so we had to shift to Rankine-Gordon. That is also mentioned here. So that's it about module 6. So these are the 6 modules which you need to study. Then I have just marked some study material. The first part in that is reference books. These are the reference books which I have marked from the syllabus and some out of my experience, and some books which I found are good and the students must refer are mentioned here. These books are not in any order of preference. I have just listed down the books based on your comfort of understanding of the subject. You can choose any book. There is no hard and fast rule which book is to be chosen. Then there are some additional study material which I have marked here. I have marked some websites. Say if you are studying the basic strength of material of Mumbai University, then you can just go through the NPTEL courses which I have marked here. They need not be certification courses. They could be just courses which have taken place in the past. So the material could be available online. So you can just go and check these courses. And for studying further strength of material, which is called as advanced strength of material, I have also marked another link of NPTEL. You can just go through it. Let's skip this portion of course gap. This is something which is not added in the syllabus, which could be taught to the students. So it's just a topic which could be added. So I'm just skipping this portion, not too much important. But if you talk about the examination point of view, there are two types of exams which are conducted. One is the internal, one is external. Internal examination is of unit test. There are two unit tests generally in Mumbai University, each of 20 marks, and the average of the two is taken. Each test is generally for 1 hour. And there is an external exam, which is the final exam. It is for 80 marks, and the grand total of both of them is 100 marks. So the theory of strength of material, which is course code MEC302, has a total weightage of 100 marks. So this is all about the mind map, which will help you know what is there in the syllabus and how much weightage is for each topic, and accordingly you can prepare. So that's it for an introduction to this course. If you have any questions regarding this video, you can let me know in the comment section. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe to my channel. I'll see you in the next session of Strength of Materials. Thank you.